I think it's a very good question. Yeah, as you know, Singapore has established the national project. They call it Smart City. And this is a very good pilot project for ASEAN as well, to have a grid. Yeah. You know, so instead of national grid, so from Singapore pilot projects, it can be expanded with respect to people center bottom up, you know, and it doesn't cost much because it's a soft power. This is the virtue of digital technology that can be implemented very fast, and it doesn't cost much. You know, this the first one. Now the second one, Dr. An, I think, mentioned it. Who is the champion? You know, who is the one that this is the problem in ASEAN. You know, because like in the European Union, all the strong, prosperous big country, Singapore is the most developed, but it's smallest. So we try to keep our mouth shut. So, but therefore, as a result of this approach, a lot of the things are through bilateral, you know, and instead of collateral. It's not because of because it just doesn't because it doesn't feasible, because Singapore is such a city state, and a lot of not a lot of prejudice, but it's a lot of past baggages, you know. If Singapore initiated, it may not be workable or acceptable. But Indonesia is the largest, but Indonesia doesn't have that capacity. It doesn't have the resources, particularly under the present president. All is concentrating in building up Indonesian physical human capacities.